the incoming chair of our organ, who is the Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation of the Republic of Zambia, Honorable Minister Danny Modizi, Minister of Defense and Veteran Affairs, representing the outgoing chair of the SADC organ on Defense and Security Cooperation, Honorable Ministers, Deputy Ministers, and SADC Troika, and the FIB troop contributing countries, Chairperson of Senior Officials, Ambassador Nanda, distinguished senior officials, chiefs of defense force and security institutions, and all delegates from SADC member states, SADC secretariats, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to welcome you all to the Republic of Namibia as we seek to strengthen our security apparatus and mechanism towards the stabilizing the SADC region. Since the last MSO Troika meeting held in January 2023 in Windhoek, our region celebrated the SADC Liberation Day on the 23rd March for the fifth time in remembrance of the heroic sacrifice of our people towards the liberation of our region and the continent, simply telling us that our forefathers and those who came before us, they have been preoccupied with peace and stability in our region, and they have played their part. Since today, the whole region is celebrating that it's an independent region. And that's why we have a responsibility to ensure that peace and stability prevail in our region. Our meeting today, Honorable Ministers, is to consider, as mentioned by the Executive Secretary, the current security situation in Eastern DRC, particularly that we are to be guided by the report from the SADC Field Assessment Mission that we have delegated to go to DRC, a mission they undertook during the month of March this year. We have also to assess the progress we have made towards the preparation of the tripartite summit of SADC, East African Community, and the International Conference of the Great Lakes region. Of course, with the support of the UN and the AU, as this was one of the decisions that was taken at the last organ Troika summit that was held on the 31st March 2023 here in Windhoek. The decision is based on the fact and the reality on the ground that all these regional groups mentioned here, they all have troops on the ground. Hence, it's felt necessary that we need to understand how we should coordinate to make sure that we give the appropriate and the right support to the people of DRC and to bring about peace and stability in that country. In the process, there's also a proposal for such a summit to become a quadruparty summit in order to accommodate the Economic Community of Central Africa states, as we know that DRC also belong to that particular regional grouping. That's very important because we know very well that in accordance to the AU programs, we're never dealing with a specific situation in a specific country. They mandate the regional grouping to which member states belong to be the one to play the role and report to the AU. However, in this situation, we find ourselves that our member states, we belong to different groupings, hence a need of that collaboration. Honorable ministers, in fact, I must make it very clear that our deliberations this afternoon are in preparation for the holding of the summit of the Organ Troika plus the SADC Troika and the troop contributing countries in the FIB, the summit that will take place tomorrow, the 8th of May. It's very important that a decision on this matter is taken at that high level, which is the level of the summit, particularly as we all know that currently DRC is to prepare itself to hold the general elections towards the end of this year. And peace and stability is very important for any elections to be in line with the SADC principles of democratic elections. Honorable ministers, I find it also important for us to remind ourselves that on the 21st of May 2023, Africa will celebrate her 60th anniversary since the formation of the Organization of African Unity that we today call the AU. We are therefore reminded that the independence of our individual countries did not come on a silver platter. Our regional integration and sovereignty of our region must therefore continue to be safeguarded at all costs. Under Agenda 2063 of the AU, when we develop the first 10 years implementation plan, one of our targets is the silencing of the guns. Unfortunately, the guns are still heard in different parts of Africa, including our region. As ministers, members of the SADC organ on defense and security cooperation, we therefore have a responsibility to see how collectively, as a region, we will be able to silence the gun in our region, including the Eastern DRC, as that's the only way we would contribute significantly to the realization of AU Agenda 2063. Having said that, honorable ministers, dear delegates, once again, welcome to Namibia, and I look forward to the successful deliberation, and unless they say anything, I can declare this extraordinary meeting of the Ministerial Committee of the Organ officially